phonies. We don't like people who are two-faced. We don't like people who are insincere. We don't like hypocrites. We don't much enjoy the company of folks who are sanctimonious. We dislike folks who say one thing to our face and another thing behind our necks. Think of Judas. He betrayed our Lord with a kiss, the sign of love and affection. But you know, both the Old Testament and the New Testament make it abundantly clear that God can't stand hypocrites. God is very merciful, but read the scriptures. He does not like anything touching his name or his worship to be phony. As Jesus points out in today's gospel according to Luke, all their works are only performed to be seen. Then he goes on to list what religious hypocrites are like. They wear wide phylacteries, long tassels. They enjoy seats of honor at banquets and in places of worship, and being honored even on the streets with obsequious titles. Let's face it, folks. I don't think anybody in Central Illinois dresses as crazily as I do. At banquets, I'm nearly always seated at the head table. And in public, people are, at least in public, are pretty respectful to use all the titles I have. John the 23rd wrote in his diary, when he first became a bishop, he realized that the splendor that surrounded his office in the church was being given to the apostolic service he was assuming. And it was there to remind him of the splendor of God's grace, that what was being signified outside should mirror what should be going on inside his life. That was certainly true for him, who is now recognized as a saint, and it should be true for me, and I would dare to say it should be true for all of you in Curcio. The deepest meaning of any Christian outward observance should be a life that truly belongs to Jesus Christ. In today's gospel, the Lord teaches us all how to better mean what we say. We should have ultimately no teacher but the Lord. No Abba but our Abba, our Father in heaven. No master, no rabbi, no teacher except for the Savior, Jesus Christ. And the greatest among us should always try to be the servant of all. We should humble ourselves so it will be God who will exalt us. I guess at every mass, most of all, we need to remember that God reads our hearts and reads them perfectly. When we hear the word of God in the scriptures, when we intercede for the church and the world, when the Lord's one perfect sacrifice on the cross is truly renewed in our midst, and most especially when we receive Holy Communion, these are never the moments to be phony. These are moments to be true. These are the essential times to really mean what we say. And then in our daily lives, live outside the walls of our churches, we should live what we say inside never fool Almighty God. As the prophet Malachi proclaims in today's first reading, I am a great king, says the Lord of hosts. Keep my ways and never break faith. Our religion should never be a show for the neighbors, but instead a sincere life lived fully and completely and over again for the Lord. Unworthy though I might be in a mission, worthy as I think you folks are, being active in Brazil, being active in your parishes, being in service groups and prayer groups, should always be to be in Christ, being and living for God and neighbor. Our relationship with the Trinity comes through our relationship with God's Son. To know Christ is to know the full revelation of who God is and what God is about. There's no room in that relationship for lies, only for surrender to the Lord and to his gift.